Hey everybody, it's Pat again, the sales engineer, and this time around, we're gonna actually redo a book that I did with bookmarks, because I'm going around doing all my bookmarks now. This is a book that I did in an earlier video from scratch. We made these nice, very thin ribbon bookmarks, very, very thin. Quarter inch? Yep, quarter of an inch. However, I've done a few with some thicker ribbon, such as this, and I really, really like it. This is like 0.4 inches. This is almost half. See? It's beautiful. Now, I've got a ton of different colors. So these were all done in pastels, kind of like that. This one I did in three groups of three. So there were three of the three different colors of ribbon that I got in those thin pieces, for a total of nine. It's a reference book, Josephus. Lived around the time of Christ. Now, in here, the interesting thing about this is that I used tacky glue to put this in, and I want to basically see how hard it's going to be to get it back out. Here, you can start to see the paper that backed this weave. There's a name for it. I can't remember the name of it, but there's this is the part that the paper binds are glued to this fabric here, and then the fabric has a backing of this cardboard here in between it and the actual cover. Now the cover along the spine here is where we glued it. So we glued these little guys, three groups of three, and I stapled them together. Just like it looks. I put them in between that piece of paper, and I glued them pretty much up against both sides. So I have to break it from both sides, break it away. The nice thing is I don't usually put more than, you know, about an inch down, so there's not going to be a lot of glue. It's not like you see people do with these business cards and stuff where they're shoving whole business cards in and gluing them, and it just becomes a huge mess with the paper. All you have here is the ribbon. So I can just pull this ribbon and it's probably going to come right out, but I don't want to ruin anything that I don't have to. So I know that I did three groups of three. So this is one whole group. It's stapled together, the three of these, and it's glued down in here. So I'm going to take them out one at a time. I'm going to reach down in here, and I'm going to see if I can't separate this bunch from the back, the binding, the spine here. And all I'm going to do is just do a little wiggling, not really a lot, because I don't want to come through here. See? I don't want to come poke out here. Yeah, I could use something duller somewhere around here. But even just wiggling it, look at that, I'm already that far down. In fact, I might have, yeah, I think I've cleared it. So I've just now taken the tacky glue off between here and the backing. Now, there's two parts, right? We still have the part we were just talking about up here. So I'm just pulling gently on it because I just want to feel it if it comes free. I'm going to put the knife in between my ribbon that I put in here. And by the way, this is cloth. This is like actual ribbon. Don't be confused. This is not, you know, Christmas birthday present kind of ribbon. This is real ribbon meant to last. So I'm going to put a little bit of pressure on it here just by holding it. And I'm going to go in here and see if I can't just work my way between the ribbon and this piece of paper. Well, there's the staple. I got the edge of one of the staples here. And there's the glue that was on it. So I'm just pulling the paper away from the ribbon best I can. I mean it's glued to the paper, right? It's not going to want to, it's going to give a fight. Okay. So not ready to give up yet. Maybe it's actually glued up against a couple of its buddies because the glue kind of squished. Maybe that's what I'm feeling here. But you can see, I can put it on both sides. Nope, she's still in there. I think I must be, the glue must be coming over to here somehow. So let's do these guys. Sure, I don't poke through the spine of the book, the back here. I think that would be something I couldn't recover from too easily. Here we go. Get that paper peeled back. That's what you're hearing. Go down a little bit. A little further than I thought. A little bit more than an inch. Have good visibility all the way down, but you can see already, right? Look what's happening. I'm re-separating. Now this gap was sort of glued together when I put glue on both sides of the ribbons. Now it's, you know, more of an opening. You can see there, that's all the way down. All the way down. So, what is holding our little guys on? Not much. So, the glue dries clear and flexible, and this is exactly what the glue looks like. Obviously, this is the paper that I tried to tear it away from, but this is what tacky glue looks like when it's dry. It looks like cellophane tape, doesn't it? Shiny. These were separate pieces, and these are stapled together. You can't see the staples underneath here. You can see some of the staple here. Again, I did this in another video. Put three pieces of ribbon together, stapled them. Done. Okay, our last three. And I like doing it like this because really, if you think about it, unlike a card that may have gone down to here like you see these other videos, I haven't destroyed this book in any way, shape, or form taking these ribbons out. And I'm going to put the other ones in here with this as well in a way that I don't destroy it putting the new ones in. Because who knows, maybe those will come out. Don't know. Okay, so you just got to be patient. Peel everything away. There we go. You can feel it's like, it is almost like tape, cellophane tape in appearance, but it's kind of gummy when you're working with the tacky glue when it's set. Let's call it that. When the glue is set. All right. So there, she's coming loose. And who's holding on? Probably not a lot. There you go. So I got a little bit of that cardboard off. Big deal. Done. Okay, you can tell by the binding and everything, this is not a really expensive book to make. God only knows how much it actually sold for. But, you know, it's got that paper that's not quite white. You can tell if you put it next to one. I mean, if you just look at this, you're like, yeah, it looks fine. But no, you put it next to a high-quality paper, and you can tell. So this... it's okay if I have it look like this. Now, but look at that. I've taken all those out of there. If you didn't even want to put any more ribbons back, what have you done? Looks just like the other end. Nothing. So, hey, pretty good. Okay, so that is the first step of what we're going to do here. I've got 18 minutes left, so, on this, before it stops on its own. So, I've gotten these colors together, and the way I was had originally put them, somehow they got a little bit rearranged, was sort of rainbowish, red, orange, yellow, but my red got way in the middle here, so I gotta take the red back out. You know the old Roy G. Biv thing? Alright, so I'm gonna do six on this one, not eight or anything. I have found that using these wider ribbons, it's a little bit more convenient if there's less of them. All right, now what do you think of that? They're going to be laid out like this. Red, orange, yellow, Roy G, no green, blue, indigo, violet poop. So I mean, I have enough colors in here. I have tons of these little guys here. I could put a green in and do a real kind of a Roy G. Biv thing, but I like these. I like this combination. I think that's nice. So, red on top. If this is the first one that you're looking at, we've discussed how to measure this a bit. I use about an inch and a half, which is going to go down into the bind. Then I take the actual length of the book. Then, because we know this is going to be here, and yes, crossing back and forth is going to take up a little room, give yourself about a half an inch or so. Then, look at how much, if you're going to hold on to this, how long this is going to have to be if you're pulling the bookmark up and then using it to open the section. Do you understand? I've been saying that right. So your bookmark is in here, like so. You want, if you started to pull it here, you couldn't quite get it all the way up. So we want to be able to pull all the way up to here and then pull our book open. So at a bare minimum, it has to be this long to do that. But we also want to have another couple of inches because we want it to even have length if we're up there. So this is our length. That will give us plenty enough to go do what we got to do. I don't even know how long this is. This is about 8 or 9 inches. Measure your own books your own way. There's 6, 12, and another 4.5. So 16.5 inches for a 9.5 inch book. I don't know if there's some sort of ratio going on because, I mean, hell, they're different widths and stuff. So that's it for Mr. Red. Red, orange, yellow. Orange is next. This is much easier now because we have the correct length. Ta-da! Yellow. These are great bright colors. And this stuff is not thin at all. This is great ribbon. Very substantial. Let's put it that way. Very substantial ribbon. Okay. We should be able to remember our colors. Oh, you know, we can change them as we go. The order, I mean, of the colors. It's really eye-catching, and if you're gay, I might just get somebody to introduce themselves and make a new friend. Although this is scarcely a perfect rainbow. I think I will do one though later. I'll do one book with red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Or if not the blue, indigo, violet, certainly violet and white, which is more like the Hindu and the Kabbalah colors of the various chakra points. But, oh, that's a whole other thing I'm into we're not going to talk about. So, here we go. 6. Very simple. So how are we going to do this? Well, the book itself, this little guy, is all of not even 2 inches. Even the paper is only less than 1 3/4, maybe 5/8. So, since I have 6, I'm going to do 2, 2, and 2. If you try to put one in and then another, what happens is they all start to affect each other, and you push on one, then before you know it, you're rearranging like crazy. Just do it the easy way. Jingers, as of now, during this video production, Joann Fabrics has these, the best scissors you can buy, anything in their store half price. These are $65. They're extraordinary. I have a couple of them. I got a thread cutter and a bunch of other ones around here somewhere. I just wait till they're on sale for half price because I can't justify $65 on a pair of scissors unless they're half price, right? So let's keep organized. Roy G. Biv, right? So red and orange are our first two. How are we doing? 21. Gotta hurry up here. Stapler. See how they're just angled a little bit? We went over that before. This one and this one. And how did I have it? Like this? Alright, so red, then orange. You see what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make the first color under the second. R-O-Y. So it's going to be... Boy, these little guys get together when you're hurrying. I like to stick. So I'm going to do something like that. Wait. Red, orange, yellow. Oh, like this. Sorry. Right. So the first color is on the left. This way when I lay them out in the book, they're actually going to be layered properly. You know, I'll actually have it layered like that. And then finally, dark blue and poop. Okay. Just like that. We got plenty on here, so when we go to trim them, you know, because each bundle is going to go in at whatever length it is, and hell, I probably measured them all wrong and different, so that's not going to be a problem. There you go, 1, 2, 3, done. Take the glue. It's actually pretty easy. Make sure it's right side up. Now's not the time to make that mistake. Now remember how I said red, orange? So we're going to do red and... Oh! You know what else I'm going to do? I'm actually going to put... I actually am going to use one of these, but I'm just going to stuff it in there with the middle one. And I will do the end like I did the other one that you saw. This one here, but I'm not going to do that here. I'm not going to bore you guys to death. Alright, so I'm going to do it the same length as these guys. I was going to measure it on the book. But I'm also going to give it a bunch, like that. I mean, I have tons of this stuff. But I can't glue it in there easily afterward, right? Because we saw how it was, how they were in there. So this will be for the second piece. It'll be on the outside, like we said before. This one ended up really good like that. I don't think I showed you that. I put this outside of the rows of ribbon, so it goes over them. This way, when I move this as the primary bookmark, I do it over the other ones, so I'm not uprooting them and putting them somewhere, and moving them and messing with the pages. Just from experience, it just works out better that way. All right, so Roy G. Biv. We're going to remember to put our colors from left to right just because I just want it done nicely. You can do it. I mean, who cares how you do it, right? You guys can do whatever you feel like. Just a dab. Just a dab. I'll lay it sideways. It's goopy, so it'll be fine. Best tool in the house. Toothpick. Just barely enough to hold it in there. We said yellow. Yellow would be next. And I'm going to have this guy behind them, because this is the center one, right? We're going to have 2, 4, 6. So this is the middle two. So I want these to be in the middle. You know, if I was thinking, I would have stapled them all together. But you know what? I just, whatever. Sorry about that. Here. Again, we're trying to have as few moving parts as possible. Look at that, barely any. That way when we go to take it out, it won't be so hard. I had twice this amount in what we pulled out, and you saw how difficult it was. Now, because this is so wide, I actually want it above these, so I'm going to move these out of the way and then put them back like that, because I want that burlap strap to be behind all of them. And it just so happens that this is not wide enough that I can separate everybody. But you see what I was going for right here, right? R-O-Y, R-O... Oh, wait. Oh, I did it backwards. Oh, that sucks. Okay. Just fix it. Here I was talking about how I wanted the colors to all line up. And then I went and messed it up. So, it was backwards, upside down, that's why. There we go. So this is the way we want it to be. And I'll just put another staple in now that I ripped that one out to keep the burlap. Staple the glue. Okay. There we go. A little more there just to keep it going. There you go. That's a pretty quick retreat of steps. Okay. Press just a bit just to get it all to just stay. And this tacky glue is really amazing. It's just it's gooey right out of the container. I'll move this around here in a second. And lastly, these two. Lightest to darkest. So, blue on my left, poop on the right. Okay, that should be the hard part. And guide it in. Like that. Check it out. So we got the red, the orange. We want that to be in front of the yellow, like that. The blue, which we want behind the dark blue, like that. This will straighten out here in a little bit, right? What do you think? Close it up. Push down. In this case, remember, because I've kind of mutilated this from having it, well, not mutilate, but, you know, I've had it, it's worked hard, let's put it that way. Can I bring this light blue in a little bit, or have I already stapled it so the angle is too much? If I push it down a little bit, I've got more flexibility, because it's only stapled at the end. And then our dark blue guy, like that. Close enough for me. Okay, press all those nice and neat. Here's our primary bookmark in the back, just like we said. It's just about damn near in line with everything. I used hardly any glue to do this, so there's no huge mess. That's it. And just trim and burn the ends and everything just like normal, and that's it. Hope you enjoy.